guys, so I'm back. I ended the other video super fast because my fiance had texted me. He had just got to work and I did not want to ignore him. So I stopped the video to go and attend to what he was saying. So I spent the next 2 days cooped up in my apartment. On the third day, I finally decide it's the right time to contact Anthony. Careful, Riley. You don't want to seem too eager. Evening, Anthony. It's Riley. We met at the art auction. Hey, I was hoping I'd hear from you. And I was worried you wouldn't remember me. Please, you're unforgettable. And I wouldn't be able to forgive myself if I didn't ask you out to dinner this weekend. Saturday, 8 p.m., I'll text you the location. Say yes. I'd love to. But wouldn't your girlfriend mind? What girlfriend? That girl was with us just a date, and I'm not seeing her anymore. Oh, can't say I'm sorry to hear that. There's nothing to worry about. I'm all yours. I'm looking forward to this weekend, and I'm already daydreaming about it. Will you wear something red? Do you want me to wear something red? I'll do my best to make your daydream come true. I can't wait. Success. I jump up with joy and do a little dance around my bedroom. But it's not long before I remember the bigger picture. Wait, this is messed up. But hey, if I end up liking Anthony, who knows what could happen? Only way, I feel like something is missing now that I haven't heard from Darren in days. What if I'm developing feelings for Darren? And just like that, my mind takes me back to the night Darren fucked Anthony's girl. To him, sex is just a tool, and so am I. I toss and turn, unable to sleep. Hours later, I hear footsteps outside my bedroom. I get up and slowly walk to the living room. Knowing how tight the security system is in this building, it can't be a burglar. And just as I thought, I found Darren sitting on the sofa with a mug, smug look on his face. Miss me? Do I miss you? Why are you even here? I'm glad you're here. No, why are you here this hour? You completely ignore me for 2 days, and then you just show up. I was about to go to sleep. Listen, Riley, I can drop by whenever I want, and today I have a good reason for visiting. In a new lesson, Darren stands up, reaches for me in a few swift steps and without warning pins me against the wall. I can feel the heat of his body pressed against mine, and it stares my pent up desire. I wait for him to kiss me, but instead he whispers, "Change into your sexiest lingerie. Make it quick." Ah. A moan escapes my lips as he gently kisses my earlobe. I slip out from under him and rush to the bedroom. I think Darren would like it if I wore this. Okay, this is hot. Should I listen to Darren and wear this sexy outfit? I only have 7 diamonds, and I know I'm not going to get coins for this. I mean diamonds for this, but I'm going to say no, change it back. I just don't feel comfortable wearing this. Besides, why should I do as Darren says? I change back into my pajamas. When I return to the living room, Darren looks me up and down. He's leaning against the wall, facing the window as the light from the fireplace dances across his perfect abs. His mood seems pensive, his face relaxed, on guard. It makes me want to touch him, but I know the moment will last. Sensing my presence, he turns around and gives me one long, assisting stare. I see if you've chosen to defy me. I'm not surprised. He raises an eyebrow, his eyes shining with amusement. He circles around me, and I instantly feel exposed and vulnerable. Finally, he moves closer, and I can smell his aftershave as he whispers in my ear. Do you know what I hate about your deal? I shake my head. I'd love to have you all to myself. Darren traces my collarbone with his fingers before bending down to kiss me. and as his lips explored the base of my neck, one of his hands cups my breast. He runs his thumb across my nipple, and I can't help but gasp. As soon as I do, he pulls away and looks into my eyes. I've always been a greedy man. I hate sharing, and I especially hate sharing with Anthony Payne. To demonstrate his point, Darren's hands move down to grab my. He squeezes it and pulls me against him so tightly that I can feel his growing erosion. I want you all to myself, Darren. I don't belong to anyone, not to you, not to Anthony. I know. That's exactly why I have to do what I came here to do, and that is to teach you another lesson in lust. He kisses me passionately, his tongue exploring my mouth, his hands running through my hair and across my body. There's suddenly such scenery in his passion. I can't help but surrender to it. I dig my fingernails into his back and hook my legs around his hips. Instead of matching my hunger, Darren breaks the kiss and untangles himself from me. Rule number one, Anthony likes to be in control. When something like this happens, don't go wild unless he asks you to. Understood. Darren kisses me again and carries me to the sofa. He then removes his belt. Rule number two, Anthony likes adventure, so expect the unexpected. I hold my breath, expecting something crazy to happen, but Darren only sets his belt down on the coffee table. He kneels in front of me and kisses the exposed skin below my navel. Darren? Rule number three, Anthony likes compliments. Don't forget to compliment him even when he sucks. He pulls himself up and hovers over me. Close enough to touch, and I'm eager to feel more of him. Come on, Darren. Try to unzip his pants, complain about the lesson, ask about his motives. I don't understand. What are you trying to do here? I'm giving you some basic information about Anthony. Do you know what number four is? No. Anthony is unpredictable, so practice is very important. Don't get frustrated or it might jeopardize our plan. Then maybe you should stop being so frustrating. I grunt in annoyance and Darren gives me a smoothing smile. Don't worry, it'll get better. He slips one hand into my by caressing my thigh with the other. It isn't long before I'm fully aroused. I spread my legs and grab onto his shoulders, wanting more, waiting for more. And all of a sudden, he stops touching me. What are you doing? Rule number five, never give him everything. Always make him hungry for more. And just like that, Darren stands up and turns to leave. You're just going to leave? Your seduction skills aren't advanced enough to tempt me into staying. Let's just hope they improve by the time you get Anthony in your bed. Good luck with your date. Just like that, I'm reminded my true challenge is yet to begin. So let's keep reading on. It's just next chapter, Seducing Anthony. Your first date with Anthony is off to a promising start. But how will it end? Lessons in Lust, Chapter 6. Chapter 6, Anthony. You guys know what I mean. It's Saturday night, and I'm getting ready for my first date with Anthony. What should I wear? He said he wanted to see me in red. It would probably be wise to play up to his fantasies. Your best parts. You look absolutely ravishing. Okay. Are you sure this is what he had in mind? A passion red coat with a phoenix fur jacket. Violet makes you feel and looks sexy? There's nothing more exciting than lace. Make him beg for your attention. This just shows off all your best parts. So I'm gonna choose this one because I don't have to use diamonds for it. You're one step closer. Got 15 coins. This is exactly what Anthony asked for. I'm sure he's gonna love it. I can't wait to see his reaction. Take a taxi to the address Anthony gave me, and a soon arrive at one of the hottest restaurants in town. The place looks simple and amusing, but as soon as I walk in, I can tell that it caters a wealthy client. Anthony's already waiting for me at one of the tables, and he greets me with a smile. Riley! You look wonderful, like you've just stepped out of my dreams. That dress looks perfect on you. Thank you. You're not so bad yourself. We exchange smiles and he pulls out a chair for me. Please, have a seat. We order a bottle of the restaurant's finest white wine before going over the menu. As we choose our meals, I use the time to relax and enjoy the moment. For the first time in my life, I don't have to choose the cheapest thing on the menu. Even if Anthony doesn't cover the bill, Darren's credit card will. So, did you buy anything at the auction? I'm afraid not. Try to remember the name of the painting Anthony and I looked at together the other night. I had my eyes set on that beautiful piece called Portrait of a Napkin, but sadly someone outbid me. That someone was me. Bingo. I should ask Anthony too. Love the chance to study a little longer. That might be difficult. Why? It's on display in my bedroom, and I don't let just anyone in there. Good. I love a man with discerning taste. He gives me a wild smile. I love talking to you. Oh, well, let me tell you a little secret. I lean across the table and whisper. The painting is lovely. But I'm far more interested in its owner. Anthony smiled and raised his glass. I drank to that. So will I. I stare at him as I drink, eyeing him as though he were the most delicious meal in the restaurant. It's hardly a challenge. He's absolutely charming. Tell me a little bit about yourself. I want to get to know you. You see, I actually have a confession to make. I looked you up, but all of your social media accounts are private. There's not much to say. My life isn't something I'm proud of. I'm what people might call an underachiever, but I suppose I did the best I could. What do you mean? I lost my parents in an accident when I was a freshman. My baby brother was only 10, so I quit college to take care of him. I've had nothing but a series of dead-end jobs ever since, that's all. Sorry for your loss, but you should be proud. Pull through a tough situation the way you did takes courage and selflessness. I admire you. I stare at him speechless. I was completely honest, thinking it best not to lie. And he's still impressed with the real me. That's the nicest thing anyone said to me in a while. Maybe you've been hanging out with the wrong people. Yes, I suppose I have. My thoughts return to Darren. Or wonder if he's the real villain in the story. Did Darren lie about Anthony? Tell me, is there anyone special in your life? Anthony wants to know if I'm seeing someone. No, there's no one. I should call the police. What? Why? A woman like you, single? That's a crime. Pretends to be outraged and I brace into laughter. You know, if all men were this fun to talk to, I'd date more often. But I bet you're one of a kind. What about you? How come you're single? Well, there are two reasons. He pauses and studies me for a second before proceeding. For starters, I've spent most of my life surrounded by a certain social circle. It feels like I've met everyone there is to meet, and dated everyone there is today. The second reason is that I have a hard time finding women who share my interest. Interesting. Could he be talking about his what, feces? But I can't help him, but I can't ask him that. These thoughts take me back to my last encounter with Aaron. Just thinking about the things he did to me while teaching me about Anthony, damn, it makes me hot. Are you okay? Yes, it's just hot in here. Yes, it must be. Yet he smiles and holds my gaze. It's an intense moment. It makes me feel even hotter. He notices this, and his gorgeous smile grows even wider. Oh, here's our food. For the next hour, we slowly enjoy our food and make pleasant small talk. Anthony tells me about his club, but keeps it brief. And his reluctance to brag about his success only makes him more endearing. And then Anthony surprised me. The thing is, I have a question I must ask you. I hope you don't take this the wrong way, but I suppose I'm feeling spontaneous tonight. And I don't want our date to end, so would you like to go back to my place? Anthony invited me over. Should I go? Oh, I'd love to. Perfect. Suddenly my phone rings. Excuse me. I reach into my bag and pull out my new phone. Darren's calling, but why? Sorry, I need to take this. It's my brother. It's a wrap. Go ahead. Lucas, hi. Darren's voice is cold. I heard you agree to go to his place. Well done. Make it memorable. You cannot be just a one-night stand to him.
I'll try to find that receipt. But how did you find out about it?
I thought I hid in my cookbook quite well.
Cute code. I've been listening to your conversation through the spyware I installed on your phone.
Whatever you say whenever your phone is around, I'll hear it.
So if you happen to have sex tonight, I hear all those nasty noises too. My cheeks get warm at the thought of Darren listening to my moans.
Oh, okay, Lucas, I'll call you back soon. I need to go.
All right, Riley. And remember, I'm closer than you think. I put my phone away and notice Anthony staring at me with open curiosity.
Seems like you and your brother are quite close. He leans forward, resting his chin on his hands. He looks to me with a thoughtful expression.
You were blushing. What happened?
Oh, nothing. He's just a pest.
How do I explain the phone call to Anthony? I'll just say Lucas.
I'm afraid I spoiled him too much. He was being a bit of a brat. He wants me to bake a cake for him and have it shipped to his college, Alex Tate. I think he's trying to prank me.
Well, I sure hope you won't actually indulge him.
Of course not.
Good.
Yeah. I sigh and I see Anthony's expression soften.
Why do I feel bad for lying to him?
Why don't we take this conversation to my place? Unless you want to order another round of dessert.
God, no. I can't eat another bite.
Me either. Shall we? Anthony drives us to his place. It's a big house, particularly at Might Manor, where he explains he has a whole wig to himself. Wow, I have no words. Perks of being a sinister son. I do live with my parents, but I only see them if I cross a dozen hallways. He shrugs and leans me inside. We spend the next half hour exchanging funny. The night moves along with a hitch. After a while, I notice his eyes wandering across my body. There's a lazy expression in his eyes, something that makes them seem more seductive. It's something new, something that wasn't there at the restaurant.
So?
Anthony places his hand on my knee and leaves it there for a second, testing my reaction. I part my lips and hold my breath. There's something sweet about the Anthony leans forward and places a soft kiss on my lips. Oh, this is okay. I only smile before kissing him back. His soft lips move expertly against mine. He's the
careful kisser, slowly exploring the limits of my comfort. But it's not long before his tongue is tasting mine. His palm slaps up my thigh. His caressiness gentle but persistent. And finally, a desperate moan escapes my lips and he loses control. Our kiss goes hungry. He eagerly pulls in my clothes. What a perfect evening with a perfect girl. Tell me, Riley, can we make the night even more perfect? Or is it too soon for that? It's your call. Anthony, our day was lovely. Do I want to take it off the night with a passion? Before he can undress me, I pull away. Is there something wrong? It's getting late. I have to go. I'm sorry. It's alright. I respect your decision. We have all the time in the world, and the last thing I want is to pressure you. Thank you. See, that's why I like you so much. He smiles and breathes out a sigh of relief. Good, I haven't ruined any chances with him. I kiss him goodbye, and Anthony walks me to the door. A taxi is waiting to take you home. I must tell you, I'm looking so forward to our next date. You're the most fantastic woman I've ever met in a while. Really? Yes. I give Anthony a bashful smile, but secretly I feel like celebrating. He's falling for me. Now I just need to see if I can trust you. I'm not easily fooled, you know. Uh-oh. Did I celebrate too early?